Let's go. Thank you. Thank you. Nixa Eagle versus Rogersville Wildcat JV volleyball game. We are now doing starting lineups, so we will be back when that is finished. Welcome back. This game will start very short, soon. Sorry, hard to start at the very beginning. So, I'm here alongside my trusty handy game partner. We got Colin Kelly on the mic today. Very skilled pitcher in the sport of baseball. Now on the mic.
We're on volleyball.
Yeah,
not baseball.
This is volleyball. I like Nix's chances on this one.
I know JV, but we've had a great season. I don't think we've lost.
Absolutely.
Especially when I traveled to last Gathering.
JV played them?
Yeah, they did.
Oh, okay.
They went 2-0.
That's amazing.
And they beat Rockbridge.
Oh, wow. We know Nix is pretty good,
we know
so
Nix is pretty good.
We're gonna see if they can keep the reign of terror.
Yeah, Amelia White.
Absolute stud.
Subs in through varsity.
Yes.
And she's starting at the junior level. I think we'll have Paige Priestley will come in. And she also plays at the varsity level. So I mean, and then you have Ava Powers, who's on the net, is just dominant every time.
Yeah, she's very tall. Served by Rogersville. Over to White. Beeson. Over to Wood. She'll tip it over. And it'll be a quick, easy point for Nixa. Be up 1-0 to start the game. Now, that was just a very smooth start for Nixa. Aniston Stennett will check in the game and go back to serve. If Nixa can keep that going, then they're going to have a pretty good game. Stennett with the serve. Rogersville. Hit. Ruth dives for it. Makes a nice play. Rogersville with the hit. Beeston sets it up. Aniston bumps it. Over to Ruth. She'll free ball it. Rogersville with the set and the hit. And it will be out of bounds.
A little too much on that.
A little bit too much. That'll be 2-0, Nixa. Stennett back to serve again. Over to Rogersville. Rogersville, the set. The hit. Couldn't quite get a solid hit on it. Hits it into the net. Nixa will go up 3-0. Stennett back for her third serve. Right to the libero. Bump set. 24 with the hit. Ruth handles it nicely. Beeston with the set over to Ava. Nice play by Rogersville, and they'll have to free ball it over. Aniston will deal with it. Beeston with the set. Ava Owens hits it. Rogersville deals with it. They'll get a hit over. Beeston over to Roth. And that will be a hit and I think a kill for Rogersville. They will go up 3-1.
I don't think they're going to put a kill up there.
Yeah, how do you say Macy's last name? Rogersville with the serve. Over to Stennett. Beeston to Wood. And it'll go off of Rogersville defender and into the stands. 4-1 mix up. Number 33 will check in for Nixa. Owens with the serve. Nixa hits it right over to Nixa. Nixa will tip it right back over. Rogersville with the hit. Owens deals with it. And it hits the top of the net and falls on the Nixa side. 4-2 Nixa. Number 7 will check in the game and go back to serve for Rogersville. Left-handed serve. Goes right to Aniston. She'll hit it over to the Rogersville side. And Rogersville with the hit. Beeston set. White with the kill. Be out on the Rogersville blocker. Knicks will go up 5-2. Have Bryn Bateman go back to serve. Jump serves. Over to Rogersville. Rogersville with the bump set. Hit. Oh, Bryn saves it with one hand. Number 20 will tip it over. Rogersville with the tip over and finds a hole in the Knicks' defense.
I believe what Bryn did there was called a pancake.
A pancake?
That's just what all the volleyball players told me is when you get one hand under it, it's like nice and flat.
I mean, that was just a great save.
Great
keep the play alive. Yeah, great pancake.
I believe that's the right terminology.
We're going to say that's a pancake, and we're going to roll with it.
I don't really know the volleyball slang these days.
Yeah, we'll try to figure it out next time. Rogersville serve over to Stennett. Bryn hits it with one hand over to White, and she'll hit it out of bounds. That'll be 5-4 Knicks up. Number 30 back for the serve. She'll hit it right to Aniston. She'll hit it over to Wyatt. Back to Kubik. Tips it over. Rogersville with the set. Rogersville with the hit. Goes off the top of the net. And they call Knicks a point.
No idea.
I think in the... I'm just going to assume that was in the net or over the line.
You know, you just gotta assume.
Yeah,
sometimes, because a lot of the time that is what it is.
Yeah.
I think it's line, but I'm not sure.
White over with amazing serve. Rogersville deals with it. Set. Set forces. Oh, that'll be a double hit on Rogersville. Amelia White will go back to serve. Up by 3. Her serve over to Rogersville. Rogersville with the bump. They'll have to free ball it. Bryn Bateman with the set over to number 10, and she will set it over, and it'll be another Nixa point. Another double hit on Rogersville. Nixa's doing a nice job and just finding ways to get the ball over and apply pressure to Rogersville right now.
Yeah, Bay 4.
White with the serve. Number 30 deals with it. Rogersville, another free ball. Ruth deals with it. Over to Bateman. Kubik with the hit. Off the top of the net. And it'll be Rogersville point. Number 10 and number 3 checking into the game. Nixa up 8-5, about to receive a serve. Rogersville serve, goes to Ruth. Bateman set, Kubik tip. Number 3 deals with it. She'll set it back over. Ruth, over to Bateman. Number 10 with a very hard hit. And Rogers, it almost hits the basketball goals. That ball was hit very hard. It went very high up in the air. Nixa up 9-5 now. Ruth. Now that was a good serve. Did you see that? It had some knuckle, and it almost looked like it had some topspin. Like dove down, and Rogersville will call a timeout, try to regather themselves.
That's an ace.
Yes, that was an ace. Good job. We'll be back after this break. And we are back. Ruth will go back to serve. The libero for Nixa. Up 10-5. So to the Rogersville side, number 30. Over to 10 with the set. Ooh, joust at the net. And it'll be Nixa point. They win the joust.
It's called a joust?
It's called a joust when they both jump up to the net. Both go for it.
Yep.
Junior Leo O'Neill with the serve. Over to Kubik. Bateman hits it over to BB. Can't quite get it over the net, and it'll be another Rogersville point. Within three now.
I think it's Bibee, and I think the announcer just pronounced the name wrong, but that could be wrong.
Okay.
Plus it's a little bit easier to say.
Yeah. White. Over to Bateman. She'll keep it in. And she touches the net, and it'll be another Rogersville point. Rogersville making a nice little comeback after the timeout. 3 points in a row. Leo McNeil. Yeah, O'Neill. My apologies. Leah O'Neill back for the serve. Off the net. Bateman has to dive by number 10. Nixa keeps it alive. Rogersville with the bump. And a little bit of an odd thing there. It'll be a lift by Rogersville. So Nixa point there. 11-8. Gracie Beeson back to serve. She'll check into the game. Over to 30. Bump. Hit by Rogersville. Right to White. Beeson set. BB hit. And it bounces off the top of the net and it'll be a Nixa point. They will be up by 4 yet again. Beeson serve. Set by Rogersville, and the hit, perfect hit, right in the middle of all the Nixa defenders, and be a kill for Rogersville.
Serving for Rogersville, number 33, Taylor Ray.
Libero for Rogersville. We'll go back to serve. Her serve. Right to Wood. She'll hit it on over to Beeson. She'll one-hand set it over to Owens, who absolutely slams it for the kill. Knicks up with a nice little four-point lead. 13-9. Aniston Sennett will go back to serve. Great serve right on over to Rogersville. We'll go for the hit, and it'll hit Nix's student section off the bounce. Nixon now up by 5, 14-9. And we'll have number 26, Aniston Sennett, to go back to serve again. Short serve, Rogersville dives for it. Leah O'Neill with the hit. Aniston bumps, and Beeson tips it over. And they call a lift?
No, that's a lift. Their hand was like starting.
Oh, hand was on the other side of that. Okay. Rogersville looking to go on a roll here, make a comeback. Down by 4. Number 9 with the serve. Over to Ruth. Beeson set. Wood with a nice tip in no man's land. And that'll be a 5-point Knicks lead.
Good touch right there.
Ava Owens will go back to serve. She'll hit it on over to the libero. 9 with the set. And that'll be a Rogersville kill for number 30. Great job by Rogersville there. That'll be number 30's second kill of the game. Rogersville serve. Over to Stennett. Right to Beeson. Right with the hit.
Boom.
Boom shakalaka. Kill for Amelia White. Be her second of the game. We'll have Bryn Bateman check back into the game, and she will go right on back to serve.
Now, does Jamie play 5 or 3?
3.
They play 3 as well?
Yeah. We'll have Bryn with a nice little serve over to O'Neill. Addie Goff bumps it up, and that'll be the third kill of the game for number 30 for Rogersville. Olivia Chapman, Jr., having a very nice game. Nixa up 16-12. Olivia Chapman back to serve. Over to Kubik. Bateman back to Kubik. She'll tip it on over. Chapman deals with it. Goff with the bump set. O'Neill with the hit. Blocked by Nixa. Goff with another set. Nixa deals with it. Amelia up for the tip. Rogersville deals with it. 2 with the set. And it'll go on Nix's side. Kubik tips it right back on over. And it'll be a 5-point Nixa lead yet again. 17-12.
And this is when Kubik's cousin puts it. Nebraska.
Quinn Kubik has 2 cousins that play for Nebraska. And one of them is the real deal.
Very athletic fan.
Yes. White with the serve. Chapman deals with it. Over to Goff. 7 hits it. Bateman keeps it alive. Over to White. She'll hit it. Right to Chapman. 9 with the set. O'Neill couldn't quite square that one up. And it'll go into the net. And it'll be a Knicks point. Up by 6. Knicks are playing very well, finding ways to get good sets, get on over the hitters. White with the serve. Over to Chapman. Right to Goff. 20. Tips it over. Bateman sets. Ruth. Over to Kubik. And it'll be blocked by Rogersville. Very nice block there. Knicks are still up by 5. Rogersville will go back to serve here. Knicks lead. Rogersville serve over to BB. Bateman, right back to BB. Chapman deals with it. Set. Rogersville hits it over. Amelia White gets it to Bateman. Kubik tips it over. Rogersville somehow keeps it alive. Rogersville with another set over. Right in between some Knicks defenders, and it'll be a 4-point Knicks lead. Getting cut down by Rogersville.
Oh,
Lee
getting cut
down. Yeah. Rogersville with the serve. Over to White. Bateman, set. 33 with the hit. Kept alive by Rogersville. 10 with the set. O'Neal tries to hit it over. Hits all the top of the net. He nicks a point.
Rogersville's starting to put a little bit of a steam section together.
Yep. I mean, I'd like to think this varsity game will be a pretty good game. Let's hope so.
I don't really know how good Rogersville varsity is, but.
Nice set by Ruth. I mean, serve. Owens blocks it over. It'll be a Knicks point. I believe Rogersville varsity lost pretty easily to Ozark. So, if that shows any comparison of.
I got you.
Our varsity teams. But we got timeout here, so we'll be back after the break. We are back at the Libero. Ruth back with the serve. I don't know over to Rogersville. Off the net, kept alive. Free ball over to White. Bateman to Owens. Puts it right into the net. It'll be a Rogersville point. 20 to 15. 5 point difference. O'Neal serve. Off the net over Ruth. Bateman to Owen. She'll tip it left-handed. Rogersville keeps it alive. Chapman with the hit, and it will be a little bit too much. It'll be a Knicks point, 21 to 15. Gracie Beeson and Taylor Wood check into the game. Beeson will go back to serve.
The ref is chatting up the substitution. Don't really understand. Make sure she gets it right.
Serve over to Rogersville. They'll handle it. 25 with the hit. And we'll go off Ava Owens. Long arms out of bounds. Sorry about that. Be 25 second kill of the game. Libero with the hit. Beeson set over to Owens. And it'll be a kill. Finds a perfect spot. 22-16. Stenna with the serve. Over to the Libero. Set by Rogersville. Chapman with a hit right over to Beeson. Ruth, White with a hit. And O'Neal deals with it, and it'll be next to point. Double hit by Rogersville. Stenna will go back to serve again. Having very much success serving for Stenna here. Hoping that we can keep Knicks' rally alive and, you know, win the set. Over to Haynes. Rogersville with the set. Chapman tips it over and it'll go out of bounds. And it'll be a Knicks point. It'll be game point. The Knicks Eagles up by 8, 24-16. Stennett will go back to serve to try to seal the first set win. Over to the libero, number 10, sets it up. Chapman tries to hit, gets a little bit off footing there. Maybe Nixo winning the first set here of the JV contest, 25-16. We will take a break and we will be back after the middle of the sets. And we're back. This time I have a different person alongside me. We got Brady Retone on the mic. Another one of my baseball teammates. He will be commentating the varsity game. Bateman over for the serve. Rogers will hit. BB with the hit. Ruth bumps it over to BB again. Hit. Dealt with by Rogersville. Kept alive. Haynes sets it over. Bateman set. Stennett with the hit, and it'll be a Rogersville point. Double hit on Nitsa. Rogersville off to a good start this set.
I wasn't in here for the last game, but I heard it was pure dominance from the red side of the court.
It definitely was. Nitsa played very well.
Or gray.
Yeah. Nitsa played very well. Whistle blown already. Did the server step on the line?
No idea, Drew.
I think that's what happened. They looked the point over there. Have Addison BB go back for the serve. We'll hit it right to number 20. Number 3 bumps it over to Stennett. She'll set it. Brennan will set it. And then Ava Owens gets the kill.
I mean, Owens uses her link there. She hardly jumps. And, I mean, right to a perfect spot.
She doesn't really have to jump that high when she's so tall.
Wildcat defense can't do anything about it.
Nothing. We'll have BB go back for another serve here. Right over to the libero. Rogersville kept alive. Libero will free ball it over to Ruth. Joust at the net. And they'll give it to Rogersville and say Bryn Bateman was in the net.
Ball just a little too far. Bateman goes right into it. All right.
All right. Well, we got Colin Kelly back.
Sorry.
Now.
Had to use the bathroom. Thank you, Brady Rito.
Owens, another kill. Pure dominance for the fourth kill of the game for Owens. And she'll check out for.
Did she have a kill while I was in the bathroom?
She did.
I think I heard it.
I heard it.
I think it shook the bathroom floor.
Holland felt the kill by Ava Owens shake the entire
so
Nixa High School.
So much power behind it. I think it might have caused an earthquake.
Okay, I mean, Macy Roots' serves are quite impressive. They knuckle and they die. And it'll be a Nixa pony. 4-2 here.
They only go to 3.
They only go to 3, so Nixa wins this. Then we'll be waiting for the varsity match between the Wildcats and the Lady Eagles. Rogersville gets a hit, blocked by the Eagles, and it'll go out of bounds. Rogersville student section throws the ball back in. Number 20, Haley Buckman, freshman. Let's go back to serve. Right to BB. Bateman with a nice set. Over to Wood. Number 7, hits it to 11. Wood sets it. And Kubik will find a way to redirect the ball and get the point for Nixa. Nixa off to another good start. Up by 2, 5-3. We'll have Paige Piercy, Gracie Beeson checking the game. Paige Piercy back to serve. Probably going to see her in the varsity matchup. Very skilled defensive specialist. Is the word?
I think so.
Piercy, the knuckler, and Rogersville can't really deal with it. It's a difficult serve.
She got a little angry there at her teammate.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to deal with a serve like that when it's just dying down and doesn't have any spin. It's hard to read, you know?
I don't know how they do that, you know?
Yeah. Piercy sets it over, serves it over. The libero with the hit from the back row. Beeson bump sets over to Wood. She'll hit it right to number 7. Addie Goff with the set, over 11. She'll get the hit, and it's out of bounds. Another Nixa point, 7-3. We'll have Piercy, but go back for another serve. Paige Piercy. Just out of bounds. And that'll be a point for Rogersville. 7-4.
Paige Piercy, just out of bounds. Best impression at the MSC announcer,
I guess. Serve over to Piercy. She'll hit the Beeson. Kubik, another tip. 11, sets it on over. Another tip by Gwynn Kubik. 11 with another hit. Dealt with by BB. And a set by Kubik, but it is called a lift by the refs. So it'll be a 7-5 ball game.
Rogersville points.
Rogersville with another serve. BB hits it to the Rogersville side, and Rogersville will just hit right back on over. 7-6. Rogersville looking more in control at the moment. Dealing with Nix's pressure better, and they're scoring because of it. They'll go back for the serve. Right over to Piercy. Nice bump to Beeson. She'll head it to Wood. 11. Free ball by Rogersville. Beeson, she'll try to dump it on off. Rogersville with the hit. And it is out of bounds, and it'll be a Nix opponent 8-6. Taylor Wood. The serve. Over to the libero. Rogersville keeps it alive, but they get in the net, and it'll be a Nix
point.
9-6. Taylor Wood. Another serve.
Mine's better.
She'll serve it. Back to Rogersville. 25, bump set. And they'll have to free ball again. Beeson with the set. Kubik just hits it on over. Dealt with by the libero. And she'll go back to hit from the back row. Ruth will deal with it nicely. Over to Beeson. BB with the hit. Dealt with by 11, but it just smacks off her left hand. Goes out of bounds.
Taylor Wood. Another serve.
How was that? Was that good?
That was pretty good. Taylor Wood with the serve. Over to the libero. 25 with the hit. Nice hit, but Piercy deals with it. Over to Beeson. Kubik. Weak hit over. Rogersville deals with it. Another bump set. Beeson, bump set. Piercy with the hit. Blocked by Rogersville. Rogersville with the hit off the top of the net. What a hit by Paige Piercy. I mean, the defensive specialist putting some power behind that. Almost a kill, but not quite. We'll have Wood go back. Another serve. Out of bounds. Rogersville point 11-7. We'll have number 3 Addie Haynes check back into the game. Served by Rogersville over to Piercy. Beeson set. BB hit. Nice hit. And it is called out of bounds. It'll be a Rogersville point. 11-8. Rogersville with the serve. By number 11, Chesney Blakely. She'll hit it over to Piercy. Hit by BB. Rogersville defenders dive and have to free ball it over. What a play by Rogersville defense. Beeson with the set. Kubik has to free ball it over. Rogersville set, hit, and it'll be a Rogersville point. 11-9 here. Rogersville gaining momentum, looking to make a comeback. We'll have number 11 Chesney Blakely back for another serve. They blow the whistle. And Nixa is out of rotation, and it will be a Rogersville point. Number 11 with another serve. Over to Wood. And a dump by Gracie Beeson. That'll be next point.
Beeson with the dump.
Kubik will go back to serve. Right over to Rogersville libero. 10 with the set. Over to Addie Haynes, and she'll get the kill right between two Nix defenders. I mean, I think we should talk about those Nix Eagle football players and what they have been able to do on the field.
Yeah, I mean, Reno, two very impressive wins.
Yeah,
you know, sure, I mean, kind of killed them. But Carthage, especially after losing 49-14 last year, I mean, that was just a murder. And then coming back into their house and taking the win.
Piercy. Ava Owens with another kill.
Too much power.
That'll be her fifth kill of the game. All right, back to what we were saying about football. Homecoming game tomorrow night against Branson.
Are you going to the game?
I believe I am. Cheer on the boys.
Cheer on the boys.
Try to go 4-0.
I'll be on the field cam again.
Of course, of course. Then we can groovy it up at homecoming tomorrow night. Bateman, jump serve. Rogersville's libero. Down with the bump set. Hits it on over. Wood. Over to Bateman. Ava Owens. Tips it on over. Very nice job there to readjust and get another kill for Ava Owens. That'll be her sixth of the game. Bateman. Over to the libero. 10 with the set. Ooh. Almost thrown over by number 20. And it's called a lift.
Oh.
And it'll be an extra point. That makes it 15-11. Nixon with another good lead this set. Looking to sweep the JV game and hopefully do that with the varsity game. Bateman. Over 11. Addie Haynes with the hit. Off Ava Owens' hands, and it'll be a Rogersville point, and they will now be within 3, 15-12. Addie Goff with the serve right into the net, and it'll be a Nixon point. BB will go back to serve. 16-12. BB with the serve. And it's way over to the left. Goes under the bleachers. Knicks is still up by 3. Hey, let's go, 16-13. Knicks the lead. Ruth. Hits it over to the Rogersville side. Rogersville will hit it. Stennett keeps it alive. Over to Ruth again. Wood will hit it on over. 33 deals with it. Goff with the set. Blakely hits it on over to BB, who makes a nice play. Wood will hit it. Tips it over. 9 with the set. Tipped over by Rogersville. Bateman. Over to Wood. Kill for Taylor Wood.
Knicks up 17-13.
I do believe it's Blakey.
Blakey? Pretty sure Blakely.
No? She's my cousin. I think I know.
Yeah. Rogersville sets it over. BB to Bateman. Kubik with the tip over. Goff sets it on up for Rogersville. Nice play by Bryn Bateman. Aniston free balls it over. Goff with the set. 11. Hits it over. Kept alive by Bryn Bateman. BB will free ball it on over. Addie Goff over to Gwinnap. 11 with the hit.
Oh.
And it'll go off BB. And up to the walkway around the court?
I call it the walking track, maybe? I don't know.
The walking track, yes.
The upper area in the Nixa gym.
17-14. Knicks lead. Rogersville with the serve. It'll go over to Aniston. Bateman set. Kubik with the kill. 18-14 now. Be Kubik's first kill of the game. And Piercy and Beeson will check in as the Rogersville times out. And we'll be back after this break.
Thank you.
back.
We got Piercy back to serve. Nixa, 7 points away from victory. Piercy with the serve. Over to 11. Libero back to 11. She'll tip it over. Paige Piercy with a dive, kept alive. Over to Kubik. She'll hit it and it'd be just out of bounds. We have 25 and 10 checking into the game for Rogersville. Tune in after this game. Lots of varsity Eagles play. Coming off to a great win against the Kickapoo Chiefs. Very big game. But now we play Rogersville. So we'll have Beeson over to BB with the hit. And another kill for a third of the game.
Taylor Wood, another serve.
She'll serve it. Kind of lofts it. Diving play by the libero. Over to 25 to hit. Ruth deals with it very nicely. Over to Beeson. BB with another kill. Her fourth of the game.
Madison Bybee. Another kill.
Oh, that one was good.
That was very good. We'll have Taylor Wood go back to serve yet again. Right over to Rogersville. Six with the bump set. Hit over by Rogersville. Beeson with the set. Over to Wood. Off the top of the net, and it falls down for Nixa. And that'll be a 6-point lead. Taylor Wood's fourth kill of the game. And another timeout called by Rogersville, and we will be back after this break. And we're back. Taylor Wood back for another serve. Knicks up 21-15. I'm not quite sure what we're waiting for. Okay, we're back. Wood with the serve, floats it. Ruth to Beeson, set. BB off the hands of Rogersville blockers and into the stands. Wood will go back for another serve. 22-15. She'll hit it right to the libero. 10, over to 6. Piercy set. Beeson dump, dealt with by Rogersville. Set, tip, blocked by Nixa. Very nice job by Nixa there. I mean, they're just playing very well today. They came out strong, and they've had good starts to each set, and they're just playing smooth and clean. Up by 8. Have Rogersville hit it over, and it'll be barely in. Seems to hit off the line. And it'll be a 23-16 ball game. Addie Haynes will check into the game. Chesney Blakey, go back to serve. She'll hit it right over the Wood. A little bit of top spin. A little bit difficult to receive. But it's okay because Knicks is still up by 6. Rogersville serve. Over to Wood. Right to Beeson. BB hit. And it'll be killed again. And it'll be Addison BB's 6th kill of the game. Very nicely done by her. 24-17. Nixa, game point. Looking to send it on over to the varsity Lady Eagles to try to get another win and sweep Rogersville. Rogersville with the set. Hit on over, and it'll be out of bounds. And that'll be a Nixa Lady Eagles winner for the JV contest. Varsity game up next, and signing off.
Yeah, signing off. You'll be at Parker Mann and Brady Retail on the mic next. So, yeah, be right back.
It's time for Nixa Volleyball. I'm Brady Retone alongside my partner, Parker Mann. Parker, how you doing?
I am doing great today. Great day for some volleyball. That's about it. Great day for some volleyball.
We have the Nixa Lady Eagles taking on the Rogersville Lady Wildcats. The Eagles, we've talked about this for the past couple. Slow start. They haven't, according to Misha's website, they have not went 0-2 before until this year, creating some diversity for the team.
Yeah, like you said, they haven't gone 0-2 since Misha has come out, which is kind of a big deal because, like, we look at last year, I like, that first game against, I believe it was Fayetteville, that was a huge tone setter for their entire season. Like, this year, I don't believe we've had that tone setter game yet.
I really haven't either, but you can consider last Thursday win against Kickapoo a tone setter. That was great volleyball from the Eagles. Dropping one set, winning the next. Dropping one set, winning the next, and then winning the fifth one. Of course, you weren't there. I don't know if you watched any of it or anything.
I watched some highlights of it. I didn't get the full game.
It was a great overall game by the Eagles. Nora Clark showed pure dominance against Kickapoo. It was just a great all-around game, and it couldn't get much better than that. Nixa versus Rogersville has been a lot of Nixa wins. Nixa has not dropped a set since October 12, 2017 at Rogersville, and the Eagles won 2-1.
In program history, Nixa is up 9-5 against Rogersville, which is a pretty large number, 9-5. Hopefully it'll be 10-5 tonight.
And the Eagles, last time they lost, 2016, getting swept, I believe, in a tournament, 2-0. So, Rogersville looking to redeem themselves here for the last, how many years? 6 years? So, it's been really slow for Rogersville against Nixa.
And it's not like this Rogersville team is a bad team either. They're a good team. Last year, they took the same by the last four state. And in that time, up to the state tournament, right before the loss, they went on a 7-game winning streak, only dropping 4 sets in that 7-game span.
I mean, that's impressive right there, because you have your 3 district games and then you have your 3 playoff games. So just going through there and winning all of those games is just, it's hard to do as a volleyball team. It's just consistency. And Rogersville showed that last year. Right now they're sitting at 2-4, dropping, I believe it's at the home opener, to Rogersville.
Against
Rogersville Republic. 3-getting swept. Was that last game or was that?
That was their very first game.
That was their very first game. So just like the Eagles, not the best start for Rogersville either. And, of course, we talked about their state run team last year. I mean, it's just a huge difference between both teams here looking at it. A lot of new faces for both sides. Rogersville dropping the first two, beating Glendale 3-2 in their next one. Dropping Carl Junction, beating Willard, and dropping to a very, very tough Ozark team who's COC champion contenders. Them and Knicks are up there. They're fighting for it. You got to consider Republic, and we talked about them losing their home opener. Republic's a good team. They're really good. Cayman Beckmeyer, dog. They're a great overall volleyball team.
Yeah, the COC will be up for grabs this season. I personally can't wait for the COC tournament just to see who gets it, because it could be one of those 3 teams that we just mentioned.
Rogersville this weekend going into the Springfield Invitational. Nixa going to the Springfield Classic. I don't think they're the same tournament, are they?
I don't believe they are.
They are not the same tournament, so 2 tournaments in Springfield going on. You have the Springfield Classic Varsity Tournament, and you have the Springfield Invitational. This weekend, the Nixa game will not be streamed as it's at the courts, and we don't really have a setup there. There's little to no room, so you can follow along. Scores will be posted on Nixa Volleyball Twitter, Nixa Volleyball Instagram, Nixa Athletics. You can find it anywhere. You can look it up. I'm sure you'll find it. Conference play starts the 20th for the Eagles. Parker, you got anything else?
Let's see. Looking for a big night from Nixa, especially off that big win from Kickapoo.
Looking for the momentum to be carried on here. Some pure dominance here from the Eagles. We have 4:38 left before first serve. We're going to send it down to Eric Michelle for starting lineups and national anthem. We'll be back after this short break, brought to you by Air Services, All Services, Heating and Cooling.
Everything's installed and up to date.
You really know your job.
Well, we have weekly training, on-site trainers and tech labs, plus knowledge testing.
I felt proud just learning how to make an Excel spreadsheet.
We make sure all our techs are trained to work on any brand of equipment.
You guys are like HVAC gurus.
Learning is a journey of inspiration, forever traversed through one's mind.
You learned that in your class.
Fortune cookie.
Breathe easier this fall. Install an air scrubber for as low as $23 a month, plus no interest.
She wears number
We're back, and back to serve for the Wildcats, number 11, Chesney Blakey. We're ready for some volleyball.
Yes, we are.
I don't know what's going on. Nah, there we go. We're started, Parker. A serve from Blakey is away. Piercy set by Bray over to Hillary Esses. Starting it off strong with a kill.
There is the start we needed and we wanted with a kill.
Checking in for Eagles, number 22, Clark Judge.
Emma Conrad, the libero, back to serve for the Lady Eagles. Set by Taylor. Dug by Piercy. Bray over to Clark. Cleared over by Webster. Back to Clark. Rolled up off the net. Tyler over to Wester. Set again by Bray. Over to Judd for the kill.
Again, with an Eagles kill. This time, Judd.
The sophomore has been great for the Eagles. Been killing it in every aspect. Conrad back to serve again. Blakey set by Tyler. Over to Chapman. Goldman. Chapman. Tyler back to Chapman. She completely misses that one. It'll be early 3-0 start for the Eagles.
It's a great start to the ball game. Exactly what Nixa wanted. Let's see if they can keep it rolling, keep that momentum going.
Conrad's serve is away. Blakey, Tyler over to Chapman, and it's going to be out of bounds. Point Lady Eagles. Conrad to serve. O'Neal, set by Tyler. Bray pushes it over. Tyler, O'Neal over to Chapman. Maddie Goldman to Clark for the kill. A little shot into the backcourt and it'll fall down.
Again, a Nixa Eagles kill. Exactly how they drew it up. Get the ball up to those big-time playmakers. Let them hammer the ball into the faces of the defenders. Exactly what they want.
Timeout. Timeout, Lady Wildcats. I was about to say Lady Eagles. I couldn't get it out. Timeout, Lady Wildcats. 5-0 is your score. We'll be back after this short break. Brought to you by Air Services, All Services, Heating and Cooling. Conrad still serving for the Eagles. Her serve is away. O'Neal set by Tyler. Over to Wester. Dug by Piercy and the battle at the net was won by Olivia Fries. The first point of set number one for the Wildcats. Annabelle Wester to serve. Piercy. Set by Bray. Back to Goldman for the kill.
Goldman plays perfectly. I don't know if you guys watching could see, but that was right into the dead zone, as we see here. The set. Boom. Right into the dead area.
Now JC Bray serve. Fisher. Tipped at the net. That's going to be a kill for Olivia Fries.
21, Olivia Fries. Checking in for Wildcats. Number 15,
up and away. Bray over to Clark for another big kill.
Again, Nora Clark, the powerful kill.
Clark's serve is away. Chapman set by Tyler. Goldman set by Bray over to Ayers. Kicked at the net out of the reach of Jason Bray. Kirsten Holmes back to serve. Holmes serve is away. Conrad set by Bray over to Judd, just out of bounds. Holmes to serve. Conrad, set by Bray, over to Ayers, and it's going to fall in.
And there's Ayers, so we don't get a replay, but again, we get another Eagles kill.
Chloe Judd, serve, Maddie Goldman with the return.
Wow.
I mean, that was just pure dominance by Goldman. Holmes over to Chapman, and Chapman, that one goes a little too far. Chloe Judd's serve is away. Holmes. Battle at the net. Won by Goldman. And it's going to be a point, Lady Eagles.
Great start up front by the Lady Eagles tonight.
Judd's serve. Cannot be returned by Chapman. Shoots that one out of bounds. 12-4. The Eagles now lead. Serve is away. Chapman cannot return this one either. Another ace for Chloe Judd. Chloe Judd's serve. Chapman, some miscommunication there.
The frustration of Rogersville right now is building up. I don't know if you saw it, but their bench players were not very happy along with the coach of the girls on the court right now.
14-4, the timeout is called by the Lady Wildcats. We'll be back after this short break, brought to you by Air Services, All Services, Heating and Cooling. Judd still serving. All the way over to Nolan. Bray. Over to Ayers. Kept alive. Pushed over, and they're going to call it to it. The Eagles now lead 15-4. And this is just going. This is heading south right now.
Knicks is going north.
Serve is a little too far. Lauren Tyler, the setter, back to serve. Bray over to Goldman, just out of bounds. It's 15-6.
Just miss on that one.
Tyler's serve is away. Clark set by Bray. Push over by Ayers. Chapman back to Tyler. Wester, she's going to get it to fall. Serve from Tyler. Goldman. Set by Bray over to Ayers. Called out of bounds. They're asking for tip at the net. And
didn't get it.
I don't think it was tipped at the net.
It was not tipped at the net.
Tyler serve a little too far. Ayer serve is away. Wilson pushed over and just out of the reach of Ayers. O'Neal, serve is away. Set by Bray. Over to Goldman. And it's going to be blocked at the net by Brooklyn Fisher. Shot out of bounds. That's.
Were you confused?
Yeah, I got a little confused there. I kind of.
It's okay.
I went blanked. Blank.
I do that all the time.
White serve. A little too far. Brooke Wilson. Not back to serve. We're going to see Chesney Blakey. Blakey serve is away. Piercy, tipped over by Bray, and what a play by J.C. Bray.
There's Bray. Haven't seen her really at all this game besides setting the ball. But there she is, getting her first kill of the night.
Perfect executed setter's dump by Bray. That one's right off the net for Emma Conrad ace. Cannot spit it out today.
It's okay, man. It's okay. Fight through.
Emma Conrad to serve. Blakey off the top of the net. The Wildcats cannot return it.
Nixa Eagles is running away with set number one here.
20-10. Conrad serving once again. O'Neal to Tyler. And Tyler hits that one out of bounds. 21-10.
Checking back in for Wildcats on the floor, Clark Wilson.
Served by Conrad. over to Wester. Bray. Dug by O'Neal. Over to Chapman. Conrad. Set by Bray. Over to Chloe Judd for the kill.
Again, Judd. No replay. I was hoping for it. It's okay. There we see the sophomore. Her second kill of the night. We are going to see her a lot this season.
Serve is away by Conrad. Wilson over to Tyler. That's into the net by Wester. 23-10. The Eagles are 2 points away from taking set number one.
Hey, Parker, how's that Chiefs game going on over there?
Well, Chiefs are currently losing 10-0 to the Chargers. Somehow. I know how, it's the defense, but.
And the offense not scoring. Tyler over to Chapman. Blocked at the net by Ava Owens.
There we see Ava Owens. Where's she at? Her 6'3". What do you call it?
6'3 build?
Build. That's what I'm looking for. Just barely has to jump in. Can block anything.
Tyler pushes it over. Owens. Back to Tyler. White set by Bray. Over to Clark. Dug by O'Neal. Wilson set by Bray once again. Over to Ava Owens. Tipped at the net, but it's going to fall in. 25-10. The Eagles take set number one.
Perfect way to end set number one. Ava Owens, like I just mentioned, her 6'3 build is what helps her get up and then put it right back down.
25-10. Set number one. All Lady Eagles. We'll be back after this short break. Brought to you by Air Services, All Services, Heating and Cooling. And we are back for set number two, but first we're going to do our senior spotlight for tonight. Number 23, Nora Clark. 6 foot senior, UT Martin commit. And right now she's showing why she's one of the best two sport athletes in the state of Missouri.
Yeah, we heard it during warmups. Eric Michelle mentioned her as the Michael Jordan of volleyball. That might just be because she wears the number 23, but I guarantee you, she plays like one of the best that she can. She plays with the best ability that she can, and she will perform night to night, every game. She will produce for you.
I mean, I'd like to say she's probably one of the player of the games for the Kickapoo game, and she's the starting forward for the ladies basketball team, and she's one of the best up there. I mean, she'll be filling in the role of Macy Conway. I mean, all of them. And she's going to prove why she's the best, one of the best multi-sport athletes in the state of Missouri. Coming here for set number two. The Eagles taking the first set, 25-10. P pure dominance.
Pretty pure dominance. Man, pretty much everyone in the starting rotation had a kill.
Except for Paige Piercy.
Except, yeah.
She's a defensive specialist.
So yeah.
You don't see that from Paige. Like,
huh. But what you do see from Paige is the balls that should be kills for the other team, and she digs or makes a great play in the backcourt.
Now we're going to see Maddie Goldman back to serve. Serve is away. Set by Tyler, tipped at the net. Clark pushes it over to O'Neal. Pushed over by Tyler. Set by Bray. Over to Hillary Estes. Dug by O'Neal. Over by Holmes. Set by Bray over to Hillary Estes. A whistle's going to be blown for a two-touch.
Two-hit.
Two,
same thing.
We're going to see Leah O'Neal move into the libero jersey for the Wildcats. Wester's serve is away. Set by Bray, over to Estes for the kill.
There is Hillary Estes, a power force for the Nixon Eagles, her second kill of the night.
Conrad to serve. O'Neal, set by Tyler, over to Chapman. Bray over to Nora Clark for the kill.
Oh my goodness.
That was killed by Nora Clark.
If I could estimate just from my eyes, I would say that ball was hit, what, like 30, 40 miles per hour?
Probably 40.
40? Is that? I don't know how fast volleyball
is. I think the
is.
Average kill is probably like 40. I can't remember. I looked it up one time and I just kind of forgot. That's going to be it. An ace for the Eagles. Brooklyn Fisher didn't know what to do. Conrad serve. That's going to be a point. Lady Wildcats. Parker, you got your information. Let's hear it.
The average kill speed for a high school athlete is 40 to 50 miles per hour. And I'd say Nora Clark is on the high end of that, if not above.
I'd like to agree with that. Blakey's serve is away. Bray over to Judd. It's actually been hit by Clark. Tyler pushed over by Freeze. Set by Bray over to Nora Clark. Just tips that one over.
Great court awareness by Nora Clark. Just like we just saw, she sent a ball 1,000 miles per hour, sees that the defenders back up and places the ball perfectly where they should have been.
J.C. Bray. Left-handed serve. Leo Neal. Tyler. Kept alive. Goldman. Can't keep it alive. It's great effort there by the Eagles.
Great effort all around the court to hustle to the ball. That is exactly what the Nixon Eagles look for.
Serve is away by Freeze. Battle out the net, won by Brooke Wilson. Is that a Chloe Judd kill? We missed it.
We missed it.
Back to serve the senior Ashlyn Billmeyer. Billmeyer's serve is away. O'Neal pushed over by Tyler. Off the net. The Eagles can't get it over.
Back in.
Eagles looking for something big here to get the momentum back rolling, just like we saw in the first set, hopefully making this one another big set.
Tyler serve, set by Bray over to Ayers, off the net, and for the first time all night long, the Lady Wildcats have the lead. It's 6-5 here in set number two. Conrad set by Bray over to Judd. Kept alive, O'Neal falling over, people. Billmeyer set by Bray, tipped over by Ayers. Tyler pushes it over, and there you give the point to the Lady Eagles. Judd serve. Ayers passed over by Bray. Bumped over by Conrad. It's going to be a kill for Brooke Wilson. 7-6.
They're calling tip on JC Bray. JC doesn't think she touched it.
To be honest with you, I did not see.
I don't think she touched it, but I think the ball was in.
Holmes back to serve. Goldman set by Bray over to Estes for another kill.
Hillary Estes, third kill of the night.
Sydney Ayers. The south ball, according to Eric Michelle. The serve is away. Pushed over Conrad. Set by Bray over to Goldman for the kill. Right on the line, Maddie Goldman.
Goldman. Powerful.
Air serve. Tipped off the net for an ace. Air serve is away. Tyler. Over to Wilson, blocked at the net. I don't think the Eagles realized the ball went back over the net and it'll fall in.
I don't believe they did. Everyone's kind of standing around. Miscommunication.
Wilson serve. Dumped over by Bray and it's going to be shot out of bounds. Maddie Goldman to serve. That's going to be an ace for Maddie Goldman.
Nice now, nine,
11-8. The Eagles lead.
Looking to add some points up here. Get ahead.
Goldman serve. Pushed over. Dug by Conrad. Bray over to Clark. Tipped at the net. O'Neal. Set by Tyler, over to Chapman. Goldman, Bray, Estes for the kill. 12-8, the Eagles lead.
Again, we see those girls in the front just powering over Rogersville right now.
Rogersville just looks tiny compared to the Eagles' front.
Because they are.
I mean, they just don't have the size the Eagles have. That's going to be a kill for Annabelle Wester.
And, I mean,
You got a difference. Class 3 volleyball school, class 5 volleyball school. It only goes up to 5 classes. They got moved down to class 3 this year. Which is crazy after they took 2nd in class 4.
Yeah.
Bray. Pushed over. Point Lady Eagles. Conrad, set by Bray, over to Goldman for the kill. Right in bounds.
Again, we just
another kill. I mean, look at the scoreboard. I know you guys watching can't see, but it's 4-0, 5-2, 3-4 for kills. That's pretty good for the second set.
14-9 is your score. We'll be back after this break. Conrad back to serve. Fisher tipped over by Freeze. Center stump by JC Bray for a kill. JC Bray's starting to look a lot like Sydney Golden in the way she plays.
Yeah, pretty much identical.
I mean, she's not to where Sydney was, but
she's getting there. I mean, like we talked about, I think it was a Jambo. We talked about how she needs to get to that level, and I believe she's on the uprise of getting to Sydney Golden.
She had a great mentor, obviously, so she's learned from the best. Conrad's serve is away. Tyler pushed over by Holmes. Set by Bray. Over to Clark. For a kill, 17-9 now. The Eagles lead.
The Eagles starting to rally the points up.
Conrad serve. Wilson, Conrad, pushed over by Bray. Pushed over right there by, wait, Craig. Lauren Tyler, I forgot her name for a second.
Back in for the Wildcats, number 11, okay. Blakey.
Great play, though.
Great play, though, by Lauren Taylor. Tyler.
Hey, man, take a breath. Thank you.
Chesney Blakey, serve is away. Set by Bray, pushed over by Nora Clark, and it'll fall in. JC Bray to serve. Serve is away. Bray, over to Clark, tipped at the net. Tyler, pushed over by Wilson. Point, Lady Eagles.
Yet another mental penalty, foul, whatever it's called in volleyball. Another two-touch for Rogersville.
Ashlyn Billmeyer, the senior to serve. Tyler, over to O'Neill. A little too far, and it's going to be a kill for Brooke Wilson.
And as we just saw, just barely missed hit by Eagles. They paid for it.
19-12. Serve is up and away. Battle won at the net by Wilson. 19-13. Tyler serve. Conrad set by Bray over to Goldman. That shot all the way up into the stands. 4 kill for Maddie Goldman. Eagles 5 away from winning set number 2. Judd serve off the top of the net, 20-14.
It wasn't an air ball. She hit something.
Serving is Holmes. Goldman over to Bray. Barry, and it's going to be a point, Lady Wildcats.
Left.
Good work, Parker.
Thanks. I was studying.
Set by Bray. Over to Barry. Blocked at the net. Kept alive by Barry. Pushed over to Goldman. Tipped over the net. O'Neill. Over to Chapman. Bill Myers set by Bray. Over to Maddie Goldman. Too far. It's 20-16. And the Wildcats making a run. Looking to come back and take set number 2 away from the Eagles. Home serve. Billmeyer. Set by Bray over to Estes for a huge kill.
Wow. Estes. 5th kill of the night. Right on the face.
I love seeing people get hit in the face during volleyball.
Does it remind you of 8th grade PE volleyball? That why?
Paige Piercy to serve. We don't need to talk about that.
You sure?
Piercy to serve. Holmes off the net. Gray over to Estes. Wester blocked at the net. Tyler over to Wester. Too far. 22-16. Eagles lead. Piercy to serve. Can't be returned by the Lady Wildcats. It's 23-16. Eagles 2 points away from taking set number 2. Piercy serve. Over to Goldman for the kill.
There again, we just a dominant front court by the Nixon Eagles.
Have you noticed? I haven't seen a volleyball game this empty. Like,
oh, I know. We talked
it's
about
weird.
That earlier. Like,
it's really
it's,
weird.
Nothing's loud, and I can hear myself talk. It's weird.
Taylor is gonna fall in for a point. Wildcats trail by 7. It's Brooke Wilson back to serve. Bray with the kill to end off set number 2. 25-17, Eagles take this one. Tomorrow night, Nixa versus Branson, homecoming game. Tune in if you cannot make it at 7 o'clock kickoff. It's going to be a big game for the Eagles after they come off a huge win. I mean, probably the biggest game of the year, Nixa versus Carthage.
Until playoffs.
Everything's installed and up to date.
You really know your job.
Well, we have weekly training, on-site trainers and tech labs, plus knowledge testing.
I felt proud just learning how to make an Excel spreadsheet.
We make sure all our techs are trained to work on any brand of equipment.
You guys are like HVAC gurus.
Learning is a journey of inspiration forever traversed through one's mind.
You learned that in your class.
Fortune cookie.
Breathe easier this fall. Install an air scrubber for as low as $23 a month, plus no interest.
We're back for set number 3, as we were really interrupted by the commercial. Talking about Nixa versus Carthage, big win for the Eagles in Carthage, first time in 10 years.
That's incredible. First time in 10 years to beat Carthage. Last year, Carthage undefeated, right?
No, not undefeated.
They weren't?
They lost to Webb City.
Carthage. Oh, yeah, you're right. Never mind. Sorry. They were undefeated against us. That's what I was trying to say.
Yeah. We hadn't beat them in 10 years until this year it happened. The Eagles ended up on top. Speaking of another Eagles team, the Lady Eagles looking to bring out the brooms. Taking the first 2. Will they do it? Pull out the brooms, get the sweep. Do we have a broom up here?
Probably somewhere. We did last year.
I want to get a broom. I want to hold it up.
Don't jinx it.
Truly been pure dominance for the Eagles as Rogersville's only had the lead twice, and that was at 6-5 in set number 2, and then 7-6 in set number 2. So it's been one decided. All day long.
All game. And it'll stay that way. I'm just being honest. Nixa will just put it on them. Like I mentioned earlier, the kills, just a stat line of kills everywhere tonight.
I believe it will be the Lady Eagles serve. I still don't know how volleyball, who serves, works. I think we need to figure that out.
I got it.
Actually, I may have lied. It looks like it's going to be Rogersville. Back to serve is Brooke Wilson, the senior. Wilson to serve. Piercy, set by Bray over to Nora Clark, blocked at the net. Kept alive by Paige Piercy. Estes over to Clark, and it's going to fall in for a kill.
Back in for the Eagles, number 22, Chloe Chubb.
Okay, so this says for the start of each set, the serve is determined by who won the previous point.
That's not true, though. It's going to be ace for
It's saying, like...
Or Emma Conrad.
Like, since Nixa won the previous point, then it would be Rogersville serve. Right?
No. Because whoever won the previous point would be the last point of the game. So it'd be Nixa serve.
Dukster's is wrong, man.
Dukster's is wrong. Set by Bray. Over to Chloe Judd for a kill.
There's the sophomore. Mentioned her name quite a bit tonight. Chloe Judd.
Conrad to serve. Served by Conrad. Holmes set by Tyler. Over to Wester. Blocked at the net by Chloe Judd.
That was powerful.
Served by Conrad. It's going to fall in for ace. So it looks like we are not keeping track of aces tonight. Or...
No, we're not.
Her number's just not up there.
Who's running the scoreboard? Come on.
It's Mr. Daniel Hartwell. Father of the Trey Hartwell.
D. Trey Hartwell. Hey, speaking of Trey, Cowboys year.
No, it's not. Conrad serve. Tyler over to Wester, and it's going to be a kill. Speaking of Trey, we saw Trey blow a call in the 7th grade A game. Nixa versus Webb City.
You talking about the fumble or fumble the drop possession?
The pass?
Yeah.
The clear fumble called a drop pass. And we were very upset, and Trey said it was a great call, but everybody and their moms knows it was a fumble.
Yeah, I believe everyone in the stadium knew it was a fumble besides Trey Hartwell.
Yeah. Annabelle Wester's serve is off the net. Parker, you okay right
there? No, I'm cramping.
That's unfortunate. That really sucks for you. JC Bray to serve. Serve by Bray is just out of bounds.
Yeah, I'm not going to move my leg all night.
Number 11, Chesney Blakey. And back in 15.
Chesney Blakey to serve. The stepsister of our tight shop operator, Cardiff Fangrove tonight. Set by Bray over to Ayers for the kill. 8-3 is the score.
I don't even want to say it anymore. I'm getting tired of saying how dominant the kills have been this game so far by the Lady Eagles.
How dominant have the kills been tonight by the Lady Eagles?
They've been so dominant.
Ashlyn Billmeyer to serve. Wilson over to Tyler, back to Blakey. Conrad over to Ayers, and it's going to be out of bounds.
Take two, Taylor.
Olivia Freeze to serve. Billmeyer set by Bray over to Ayers. Shot out of bounds for a Lady Eagles point.
Back in for the Eagles, for Hillary Estes.
Another early start for the Lady Eagles, up 9-4 already here in the third.
Serve from Judd. O'Neal pushed over.
And they're going to call a lift. On Lauren Tyler.
I believe that's the right call.
Do we have a replay of it? Do we have a replay? Oh.
Well, we missed
it. That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. We missed it. Maddie Goldman gets the kill on the return.
9-4 after that kill.
Did you say 9-4?
11-4. I'm sorry.
Timeout, Lady Wildcats. We'll be back after this short break brought to you by Air Services, All Services, Heating and Cooling.
Everything's installed and up to date.
You really know your job.
Well, we have weekly training, on-site trainers and tech labs, plus knowledge testing.
I felt proud just learning how to make an Excel spreadsheet.
We make sure all our techs are trained to work on any brand of equipment.
You guys are like HVAC gurus.
Learning is a journey of inspiration, forever traversed through one's mind.
You learned that in your class.
Fortune cookie.
Breathe easier this fall. Install an air scrubber for as low as $23 a month, plus no interest.
Bill Meyer over to Bray, over to Hillary Estes for a kill.
Powerful.
So I may have heard the worst fantasy football of all time.
I was not serious.
No, Parker was sitting here, and he just said he wanted to start the Chargers defense, but he didn't. But his quarterback's Patrick Mahomes. That just doesn't
happen. Exactly. I didn't start the Chargers defense.
But you wanted to. Because
my other defense is the Bills. And let me just see who they play. So I didn't even see who they play. I just know not to pick the Chargers defense because I had Patrick Mahomes starting.
But you said you wish you did.
Yeah, because they have the same points pretty much. And Mahomes almost got hurt.
Bray over to Estes for the kill.
Yeah, the Bills have Tennessee. Derrick Henry's going to go out there and stiff arm every living soul on the field. I'm going to get like 3 points out of it.
The take just didn't make any sense.
You don't make any sense.
Air serve. Tyler bumped over by O'Neal and it's put out of bounds. 14-5. Lady Eagles. When do you get a broom up here? I want one bad. Bring out the brooms.
Sweep. Sweep alert.
Tyler. Conrad. Dumped over by Bray. Tipped at the net. Kept alive by Emma Conrad. Goldman. Over to Wester. Set by Bray. Over to Maddie Goldman. Kept alive, and it's going to be out of bounds. Great volley there by both teams.
Great. Yeah, great volley by both teams.
It's okay. Kirsten Holmes back to serve. Home serve. Conrad. Set by Bray. Point Lady Wildcats.
Two touch on the Eagles.
You guys want to take Brandon Clark? Conrad. Set by Bray over to Hillary Estes. Wow. Perfect by Estes.
That couldn't be more perfect classes.
Perfection. Maddie Goldman to serve. Tyler over to Wilson, and it's going to be a point
Lady Eagles. 16-7. Goldman serve. Over to Wester, Piercy. Goldman to Clark. Tyler to Chapman. Tipped at the net, but can't be kept alive.
Back in for the Eagles, number 15, Amelia White.
See Amelia White come into the game. Served by Wilson, set by Bray. To Clark, tipped at the net. Bray. Back to White. And it's going to fall in 17-8. 8 points away from taking set number three.
And the sweep.
Conrad serve. Tyler over to Wester. Kept alive by Bray. Bumped over by Piercy. Tyler pushed over. Bray over to Judd, ends out of bounds. 17-9. Serve from Wester's away. From White. Set by Tyler. Bray. Pushed over, and it's going to fall in.
Back in for the Wildcats, number five, Brooklyn Fisher. And back in for the Eagles, 27, the senior city.
JC Bray to serve. Serve is up and away. Shot out of bounds by Brooke Wilson. It's going to be ace for JC Bray. Eagles six away from taking it all. Nice serve. Over to Freeze. Bray. Bumped over by Clark. O'Neal. Tipped at the net. Kept alive by Bray. Too far from Judd. What a play from JC Bray.
Great play by JC Bray. Sad that we couldn't convert, but all around great effort.
It was just an all around great play by JC Bray, showing that she's an athlete. White, set by Bray, over to Ayers. Fisher, over to Freeze, and off the forehead of JC Bray. Chesney Blakey to serve. It's going to be ace for Chesney Blakey. I think White May thought she was going to leave it and decided to go after it.
Yeah.
She realized it probably wasn't the best idea.
And then once you either commit or you don't, and if you do.
She hesitated.
Yeah. Any hezzy is a no-go.
Over to Nora Clark. It's going to be inbounds. It's 19-13 as the Wildcats are making a run here.
Might need to
put back the brooms for a second.
Put them back in the closet.
Blakey to serve. Clark set by Bray over to Sydney Ayers. Out of bounds. It's 19-14. The Wildcats four shy from tying it. Five shy from tying it. Thought it was 15.
Nope.
You know, basic math is hard.
That's what I'm saying, man.
Blakey back to serve. Serve is out of bounds, just 20-14. We're going to see Ashlyn Billmeyer to serve. Billmeyer serve is up and away. That's going to be an ace for Ashlyn Billmeyer as it shot off the hands of Chesney Blakey. The Eagles looking to move to 3-2, just above 500. Served by Billmeyer. O'Neal. Tyler over to Freeze for the kill. 21-15.
Back in the Wildcats, number 4, Brooke Wilson.
Just a powerful kill by Freeze.
Served by Freeze. Bray over to Barry for the kill. The Eagles three shot.
Bring back out my broom.
Coming to sweep the floors. We see Ava Owens and Gracie Beeson to serve. And if I'm not wrong, this will be Gracie Beeson's first varsity appearance. Pushed over, kept alive by Billmeyer. Bumped over by Beeson. Tyler, set by Bray. Over to White, placed perfectly for the kill.
Perfect kill by Amelia White. Cross court, right in front of the line.
Beeson to serve. O'Neal set by Tyler. Over to Wilson. Barry for a kill. 24-15. The Eagles won.
1 point Uno. Away. Uno mas.
Uno mas. One more.
I'm
taking it home. We're going to see Taylor Wood enter. Beeson. Blakey set by Tyler. Blocked at the net. And the Eagles take out the brooms for the sweep. 25-15. Pure dominance from the girls in gray.
I'm sweeping right now.
Sweeping the floor.
Sweeping the floor. Just pure dominance by the Lady Eagles. I lost track of how many kills and blocks we had up front. It was so many. I got bored with all the numbers. I stopped counting. But I don't know. You go.
The Eagles take this one, moving right above 500, sitting in at 3-2. Great game. Pure dominance from the Eagles. And this is the Eagles volleyball team we like to see. I mean, it's been fun. These past two games, Kickapoo, Rogersville, it's been a fun team to watch. And I'm excited for the rest of the season.
I am very excited for the rest of the season. And like we mentioned this earlier, we're going to talk about JC Bray just a minute, just for a solid second. She is filling those big shoes of Sydney Golden. And I will talk about this all season because that's how good Sydney Golden was. And JC Bray is playing at that level right now with the ability, that play we made where she was going back, hit the ball up to save a great play. That is what they needed. And with the way she plays, the style she plays, is forming into what Sydney Golden was.
20-5-15. What was the score of set number 3? The Eagles take it 3-0 tonight against Rogersville. Go and play in the Springfield Cath Classic this weekend, and then go on Tuesday night to take on Neosho for a first conference game. I believe it's Neosho and Republic this week. I will not be on the call on Tuesday, but Thursday I will be. 25-15. Got anything else to say, Parker?
Go Chiefs.
I'm Brady Retone alongside my partner,
Parker Mass.
Signing off.
Guy.
Mr. Callahan, you're smiling.
I'm proud to say that Air Service and All Service Plumbing now offers a nationally certified HVAC registered apprenticeship program.
A 3-year program, extensive classroom and field training with written and practical exams.
And once they pass, they're journeyman HVAC technicians.
So techs who work on your home are in the process or have completed the training program.
And that ensures the highest quality of service.
You know, Mr. Callahan, I like it when you smile.
Don't get used to it.